Welcome to Tri-Church Worship. We gather as one community of faith across the miles, online, over the phone, and in person. We gather to worship our living God. Today we celebrate Pentecost, the gift of the Holy Spirit. As we begin, we welcome the Spirit of the living God. Let us pray.
Merciful God, the gift of Jesus' life in us is visible in the way we witness to the fruitfulness of that gift. We know that the fruit of the Spirit consists of love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Yet so often we put conditions on our love and joy and peace. These gifts are difficult to discern when our words and actions deny their presence. That we forget what it's like to be patient. We find ourselves neglecting the needs of others because we run out of time to be kind to others. When we make self-centered decisions rather than Christ-centered ones, our understanding of your goodness and faithfulness is weakened and our discipleship lacks credibility. At times it is easy to believe one can't get anywhere by exercising a spirit of gentleness or even self-control.
Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on me. Melt me.
Reconciled through Christ, be made new in Christ, you are forgiven. For it is by grace that you have been saved. You are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus to do good works. Thanks be to God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit is with you always. Let us pray. Mighty God, you breathe life into our bones, and your Spirit brings truth to the world. Send us this Spirit, transform us by your truth, and give us language to proclaim your gospel through word and deed. Amen.
Let us pray. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Spirit of the living God, fall fresh on us. Holy God, send your Spirit to fall fresh upon us and upon all who proclaim to us the Scriptures. Mold our minds and melt our hearts to receive what the Spirit is saying to the churches through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
A reading from Ezekiel. The hand of the Lord came upon me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me down in the middle of the valley. It was full of bones. He led me all around them. There were very many lying in the valley, and they were very dry. He said to me, "Mortal, can these bones live?" I answered, "O Lord God, you know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones, and say to them, 'O dry bones, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God to these bones, I will cause breath to enter you, and you shall live. I will lay sinews on you, and will cause flesh to come upon you, and cover you with skin, and put breath in you, and you shall live, and you shall know that I am the Lord.' So I prophesied as I had been commanded, and as I prophesied, suddenly there was a noise, a rattling, and the bones came together, bone to its bone. I looked, and there were sinews on them, and flesh had come upon them, and skin had covered them, but there was no breath in them. Then he said to me, 'Prophesy to the breath, prophesy, mortal, and say to the breath, Thus says the Lord God, Come from the four winds, O breath, and breathe upon these slain, that they may live.' I prophesied as he commanded me, and the breath came into them, and they lived and stood on their feet, a vast multitude. Then he said to me, 'Mortal, these bones are the whole house of Israel. They say, Our bones are dried up, and our hope is lost. We are cut off completely. Therefore, prophesy and say to them, Thus says the Lord God, I am going to open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people. And I will bring you back to the land of Israel, and you shall know that I am the Lord. When I open your graves and bring you up from your graves, O my people, I will put my spirit within you, and you shall live. And I will place you on your own soil. Then you shall know that I, the Lord, have spoken and will act, says the Lord." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Reading from Romans chapter 8. We know that the whole creation has been groaning in labor pains until now. And not only the creation, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, groan inwardly while we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies. For in hope we were saved. Now hope that is seen is not hope. For who hopes for what is seen? But if we hope for what we do not see, we wait for it with patience. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weakness, for we do not know how to pray as we ought. But that very Spirit intercedes with sighs too deep for words. And God, who searches the heart, knows what is the mind of the Spirit, because the Spirit intercedes for the saints according to the will of God. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King, heirs of salvation, trusting His promise, faithfully now God's praise we sing. Baptized in water, baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, marked with the sign of Christ our King. Born of the Spirit, we are God's children, joyfully now God's praise we sing.
A reading from Acts. In the first book, Theophilus, I wrote about all that Jesus did and taught from the beginning until the day when Jesus was taken up to heaven after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. After his suffering, Jesus presented himself alive to them by many convincing proofs, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While staying with them, Jesus ordered them not to leave Jerusalem, but to wait there for the promise of the Father. "This," Jesus said, "is what you have heard from me. For John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now." So when they had come together, they asked Jesus, "Lord, is this the time when you will restore the kingdom to Israel?" Jesus replied, "It is not for you to know the times or the periods that the Father has set by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." When the day of Pentecost had come, they were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. This is good news. Thanks be to God. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. I wonder, do you feel power? Do you feel like the Holy Spirit has come upon you? Would you really think about it? Do you feel the Holy Spirit? Do you feel power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you? That you would be witnesses of God in this time and space. People of God, whether you feel it or not, we believe and trust that it is as it says in the scriptures, you are my witnesses. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. Beloved, you are God's witnesses. Your lives bear witness to God. As God's self is revealed in and through, and sometimes in spite of you and me and all of humanity, God is at work everywhere. The Holy Spirit is set free among the earth and is able, is working. And God has given us power as we receive the Holy Spirit to bear witness to God. Now, I can hear some of you saying, at least in your heads, when do I bear witness to God? What could you possibly mean about receiving power? Here's the thing. The Holy Spirit calls, gathers, enlightens, and makes holy. The Holy Spirit blows through your life. And as you lean into God's love, as you live in the truth that you are beloved, that all of humanity is beloved and worthy of love and belonging, all are created in the image of God. All matter, regardless of size or ability or skin tone or kindness level. All people matter. And as you live in God's love and share it with other people, as you receive and know God more, your life bears witness to God's self in how you live, in what you say, and what you do. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you. You are my witnesses. You might wonder how you witness to God. You are a witness of God in your words, in your actions, in your worship, in your service, in your giving, in your prayers. You are a witness to God in how you live. And here's the thing. We'll never get it perfect. Your life bears witness in that you receive daily grace. For it is by grace you have been saved through faith. This is the gift of God. Your life bears witness as you lean into God's grace, as you welcome forgiveness, as you welcome God's peace, as you welcome God to meet you in reality. Your life bears witness to Jesus. You are beloved. You are never alone. The Holy Spirit has come upon you. In the waters of baptism, God has claimed you as God's own. And God's Spirit is at work in the world in ways we do not even understand. May you remember daily that God is with you. May you welcome God. God, you say in your word, we will receive power as the Holy Spirit comes upon us. Holy Spirit, we welcome you to come upon us. Move us to respond to others in need. Perhaps Acts 1:8 can become a prayer of sorts for us. Oh God, would you meet us in reality? Holy Spirit, come with your power and help my life to bear witness to you. May you encounter the Holy Spirit in a fresh and new way this Pentecost. May the Holy Spirit come upon you. May you receive power to bear witness to Jesus in word and deed as you live in and live out love. And may you welcome the grace that God freely gives when we frankly just don't get it right, when we deny God's love or deny our own belovedness or others. We sin. We separate ourselves from God and others, and yet God makes a way for us through Jesus, covering over our sin, making us new, ushering us into life again and again. May your life bear witness to being continually made new in Christ. You will receive power when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you are my witnesses, says Jesus. May we live like it. May we live like it. Our hymn of the day today is, Have Thine Own Way, Lord. Perhaps part of following and bearing witness to God is living with open hands, that we would welcome the Spirit's leading throughout the day, that we would live mindful of God's love, and that we would share that love with others. Let us sing, pray, and live. Have thine own way, Lord. Amen.
Have thine own way. hold o'er my being absolute sway. Fill with thy spirit till all shall see Christ only, always living in me.
As it says in Acts 2, when the day of Pentecost came, the 12 disciples, now with Matthias, were together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house. And they saw what looked like tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. On this day of Pentecost, we remember Christ's great promise to us. Before Jesus ascended from the earth, Jesus said to the disciples in Acts 1, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and in all Judea and to the ends of the earth." Let us pray.
Thank you, God, for your Spirit, who gathers us together over time and space. May we accept your gift with grace and wisdom, hope and fearlessness. Give us strength and wisdom to act on your will.
And on this day, we marvel at the possibility of God's Holy Spirit here with us. For in the last days, says the prophet Joel, the Lord will show wonders in the heavens and signs on the earth below. Blood, fire, smoke, a darkened sun, and a moon turned to blood.
God Almighty, we are humbled in your awesome presence. We are reminded of our weakness, our insignificance. Ashamed, we pray for mercy.
But on this day, we remember the sacrifice that made this gift possible, the perfect lamb who was slain, the blood that was spilled, the curtain that was torn in two. And we remember the stone that was rolled away. As it says in Scripture, everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved.
Praise be to the Father. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain, and holy is your precious Spirit. For we were lost in the depths, and you have found us and invited us to your table. Now we are bearers of your holy name.
And on this day, through the prompting of the Holy Spirit within us, we put aside our grievances. We reach out to those around us. We lift up our talents and gifts. We ask to be filled and then poured out. We are no longer satisfied with life not lived abundantly. As God says in the Scriptures, "I will pour out my Spirit on all people. Your children, they will prophesy. The young will see visions, the old, they will have dreams. I will pour out my Spirit upon you, and you will prophesy." And all of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them.
Lord, we receive your gift with anticipation. Make us the hands and feet of your invisible Spirit and shine the light of Christ Jesus through our words and actions. Lord, give us the ability to speak not in languages of hate or greed, complacency or discontent, but in love and peace, mercy and kindness, in generosity and benevolence, in humility and patience, and in truthful words of encouragement.
On this day of Pentecost, may the moving of your Spirit not be to us a chasing after the wind, but a warm breeze of hope. May the church act as one body to bring love, joy, and your holy truth to every generation and people. And may we always have the wisdom to receive these things graciously. May we receive the Spirit as they did in Acts, where it says, "Therefore, my heart is glad and my tongue rejoices. My body will live in hope because you will not abandon me to the grave, nor will you let your Holy One see decay. You have made known to me the paths of life. You will fill me with joy in your presence.
Praise and glory, honor and thanks be to the Father, and to Christ Jesus, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The peace of Christ is with you always. Enjoy it and share it.
With you and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give our thanks and praise. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who rose beyond the bounds of death as Jesus had promised, poured out your spirit of life and power upon the chosen disciples. At this, the whole earth exults in boundless joy. And so with the church on earth, with the host of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth, for you had mercy on us and have given your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. We give you thanks for the priceless grace you have bestowed upon us through Jesus Christ, who died upon the tree of Calvary and rose again to make us living branches, drawing our life from him and bearing fruit in all the world. Send your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth and power, to renew our faith as we receive our crucified and risen Lord, who comes to us in his body and blood. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks. He gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup and gave thanks and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
This is the Lord's table, and you are welcome here. Receive God's love for you. Come, Creator. Come, Redeemer. Come, Holy Spirit. The body of Christ given in love for you. The blood of Christ shed for you. Amen. Let us pray. Creator, you provide the true bread from heaven, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Grant that we may abide in Christ and Christ in us, that we may be filled with the power of the Holy Spirit all of our days. Amen.
Go out into the world in peace. Have courage. Hold on to what is good. Return no evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak and help the suffering. Honor all people. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. Almighty God, Creator, Savior, and Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Come, Holy Spirit, come.
Spirit of God goes with you. Live out love. With God's help, we will.
Our streets and land, set your church.